The job of National Security Advisor does not require Senate confirmation. That's good news for Ambassador John Bolton, the incoming National Security Advisor, who has dealt with congressional skepticism before. While Fox viewers here, of course, most recently remember him as a Fox News contributor on foreign policy issues, and several news outlets today repeatedly referred to the ambassador as a talking head, National Security correspondent Jennifer Griffin is at the Pentagon with details on the career of President Trump's new National Security Advisor. Good evening, Jennifer.
Good evening, Brett. Ambassador John Bolton is no stranger to Washington. In 2005, he received a recess appointment from President Bush to serve as UN ambassador because his contentious past made confirmation impossible. Bolton began his career during the Reagan administration at USAID before moving to the Justice Department as Assistant Attorney General. Under President George H.W. Bush, he served as Assistant Secretary of State for International Organization and oversaw U.S. involvement in groups like the UN, of which Bolton was no fan, famously saying in 1994, "The Secretariat building in New York has 38 stories. If you lost 10 stories today, it wouldn't make a bit of difference." A Yale-educated lawyer, Bolton rose to prominence during the Florida recount in 2000, dispatched by Republicans to look over the shoulders of Palm Beach County canvassing board members as they examined punch card ballots in search of hanging chads. A few months later, Bolton was rewarded with an appointment to serve as Undersecretary of State for Arms Control. He was the Bush administration's point man on weapons of mass destruction until 2005. A proponent of the Iraq War, he was involved in the negotiated handover of Libya's WMD, transporting Libya's entire nuclear weapons program to Oak Ridge, Tennessee after the invasion of Iraq. Bolton has called for regime change in Iran, along with North Korea, and recently penned the legal case for striking North Korea first. In 2003, Bolton represented the U.S. at six-party talks designed to prevent North Korea from going nuclear. 3 years later, Kim Jong-un's father conducted his country's first nuclear test. Brett?
Jennifer Griffin, live at the Pentagon. Jennifer, thank you.